In an inner join, only records with matching values in the foreign key fields of the related tables are included in the resulting dynaset. For example, we are doing an inner join between the client and the payments table. If you look at the QBE grid, there's just a line between the two keys. If you just see a line between the tables, that represents an inner join in Microsoft Access. Inner join is the default join type. Notice on the grid, we're grouping by client ID, first name, last name, and we're summing the payments. The bottom of the screen is the resulting dynaset. Notice the client ID on both tables is the same because we're joining the records and it makes one big virtual record. If you remember from the research papers database, we had approximately 16 clients, but only the clients who have made a payment are showing on this dynaset. On the other hand, with an outer join, it will display all the records from one table and only the matching records from the other table. Here we have an outer join relative to the client table, meaning we will display all the records from the client table and only matching records from the payments table. Notice the outer join. There's an arrow. The arrow signifies that we're doing an outer join relative to the clients table. And we're creating the same query, the group by sum. And notice now when it runs the query, the resulting dynaset will show all of our clients regardless of whether they've made a payment or not. Before I continue, I want to show you how to create an outer join. It's very easy. You double-click between the line, and you select the option. Number one is only include rows where the join fields from both tables are equal. That's an inner join, the default type. Number two says include all records from the client and only those records from payments where the join fields are equal. And that's what I want. When I click OK, the arrow displays, I'll put it this way so it looks like the slide, and there's our outer join. Now let's look at an outer join between the client payments table relative to the payments table. Notice the arrow. Okay, we're creating the same query. In this case, you have the resulting dynaset. Again, there are 16 records in the client table, but we're not displaying all those records because we are only displaying all the records from the payments table and only matching records from the client table. If we had any orphans, which we shouldn't, because we should create this database orphan-free, if we did, it would show the orphan from the payments table and no client ID associated with it.